Good morning everyone and welcome to the Sims Queenie's little YouTube channel and a speed build that I named Nine Tile Home. We are building in the world of Henford on Bagley in the cottage living pack, and we are going to use only nine tiles today. I've seen tons of YouTubers doing this channel, like 5x5, 4x4, 3x3, even a 2x2 house. That was crazy. Indeed crazy. But in that house, everything was so squished that I honestly didn't like it. This is also extremely squished, but it's movable. You know, the Sim can walk around in there and use everything. And it's kind of hard, so I'm gonna bring in a Sim very soon to test everything as I go along, because I really don't like it when you build a house and you all finished, you decorated it, and you're so happy with it, and then something's wrong, and then you have to start moving everything around. I think that's kind of a bummer. So, well, at least here's our little tiny house. And I actually do think that it is kind of cute from the outside. It will also be a starter home in the end. Even with all the landscaping, it will not reach the 20,000K limit. And now I had to put move object on. And if that's a cheat, well, then I've been cheating in this challenge. But I use move object all the time in all my builds. I honestly do not know how people can build without move object on. But I chose this beautiful door from the cottage living pack. It's like country kitchen, and it's, oh, I just mixed the names up. And those windows are from base game, because I really thought this house could do with some nice windows and some lighting. And now we come to the least favorite part of the build. It's my tiny, tiny, super squished bathroom. And it actually is functional, but it's just a base game toilet. It's gonna be a base game sink. And then I'm gonna use this magical shower from the university pack. And it actually is functional. It's a bit outside the bathroom, I know. And one of the faucets are touching the windows. But honestly, in this build, I do not care. It's functional. But right here, I'm not so sure. So I will soon bring in a Sim. I just picked her from the gallery. I don't even know her name. I just put her down. But this is a university little fridge. And dream home decorator oven. It's just this thing you can put on the table, so you can just put it on top of things. Really good. An island counter from cottage living, and a small chair or a stool, like a bar stool. And you can put a computer and sit down and work. But if you want to cook, you need to put the computer back in the Sims inventory. But that's an easy thing to do. And this island counter is also used for the Sim to chop vegetables and prepare food. And now we're placing down a bed, my every time go-to bed from Eco Lifestyle. And this perfect piece of furniture that includes both a stereo, books, and a TV from Tiny Living. And then I want a nice mirror in the bathroom, because in this small space, I can't find it. No, I can't find it. I can't find a place to put a dresser. There is absolutely no space for a dresser in here. Because see, here I brought the sim in and I forgot to put a mailbox. So now I, for 1 second, I'm about to lose my mind. I was like, what, why can't you enter the house? And then I saw the mailbox in front of the door. So of course she couldn't enter. But I am picking out this small wall-mounted mailbox from Snowy Escape. And in she goes. Can she watch TV? Can she read a book? Can she listen to music? And everything was actually functional. I wasn't sure that she was going to reach for that book, but she did. That made me really happy. And now she's watching a movie. So it is working. And now I want her to put her computer in her inventory and start cooking something to see if everything is functional. But she's not cooking, she's just watching the TV. So I had to turn the TV off. Oh, you can see a fox over there. She's walking outside. And in the game, as you can see, it's autumn or fall. And I just love Hensford and Bagley in the fall. All the gorgeous red trees and shrubs, or if you call it bushes, that's up to you. No, don't sit on the bed. Go and sit on your bar stool, please. Yes, it's functional. Can she still use the bathroom? Yes. Can she wash her hands? And can she take a brisk shower? Please be functional. Ah, perfect. As you can see, she can do everything in this house. Fully functional 9-tile building. Yeah. That's good, actually. So now it's just time for some decoration and some lights. Yeah. Because of the nooks in this building, I actually needed 3 lights. I never thought I would need 3 lights in a 9-tile home. And some nice wooden floors and some tiles in the 1-square bathroom. But I actually do need to separate the bathroom in some kind of way, and I will do that. I will just move the shower at first and put a wall up. And I just put the game back on because I wanted to close the door. It was disturbing me. It was in the way. So the wall ain't gonna stay there. It's just so that I can put up some curtains, some dividers. See, I took the wall down again and I'm putting the shower back. In the beginning, I was leaning towards keeping this house in a blue shade, but since I used those curtains and I actually did like them, so I'm starting to use more yellow in a while. You'll see. And now I want some decorations on the walls. I actually like that. It's like a chalkboard where you can write up some recipes or some notes so you remember what kind of meetings you're supposed to go to, or if you're invited to a party. And here I used a small piece from the Journey to Batuu, the Star Wars pack. And I normally put a clock in those circular things. And now I put up a small, beautiful, it's like a mirror and a plant and some nice rocks at the same time in a beautiful frame. I like that. I would have liked to have that in real life. Now I'm looking for some utensils to hang above the small oven and some more curtains. I think it's about here when I start to realize that I use too much blue in the furniture. So I'm changing it into yellow. At least the counter and the bed is a little bit more yellow now. And I won't change the color of the fridge. I just tried it out. And this is where I grab a clock to put inside That piece from Journey to Batuu. I'm not actually sure what to call that piece. It's not a painting. It's not a clock. It's not... I don't know, but it's pretty. And now I'm using some wallpapers from the Moschino pack, and honestly, I don't ever think I've used that wallpaper in my life. I might be lying now, and that was not my intention. Then I sized up a small rug, and it almost covered the entire house. The floor of the entire house, at least. So let's see if you can go and clean up this plate, and then put your computer back on the counter. The island counter. Yeah, everything is functional still. Some more decorations, some flowers and stuff, because we have still got a lot of money left. 7,280 simoleons. And I do think that those plants were from Tiny Living. And this flower box is, I think that's Space Game. And I had to shrink it down because I was really scared that she wouldn't be able to use the front door and be trapped in there. Some more plants perhaps. Or paintings. Or plants. Yeah, plants. Let's see what we can come up with. Oh, of course. Ever go to plants from the Blooming Rooms kit. That kit is actually one of my absolute favorite kits or packs, or call it whatever you want. The Blooming Room kit is amazing. I was so happy. I went so overboard in all my bills after that kit was released. Oh, look at all the trees. They are so gorgeous in that color. And when you pay for landscaping, the money just vanishes. But now it was still not even 10,000, so we could go on for a while. And now I realize that I want that adorable little fox window above the door. It's not usable. You can't see it from the inside, but it's just such a pretty decoration from the outside. And now I want a dumpster. That is one of the most amazing pieces in the entire game, according to me. Eco Lifestyle is my forever go-to world. I adore that pack, as I adore this pack in Hensfeld and Bagley. It's those two packs I can't live without. And now I'm using a few planters from Eco Lifestyle. I actually think that made the house even cuter. But this dumpster is so good because you can like throw away a plate and then it turns into a bike or a shower or a fridge. Something. It's amazing. And it's so much fun to have a dumpster when you play like Rags to Riches challenges or something. So now I'm just decorating the outside of the house before I continue into giving her some skill building items. Like, I think I'll put down an easel and a woodworking table, beehive, planters, and one of those adorable barbecues. It's Space Game, I'm sure, but we got it in a celebration period, like South America or Mexico or something, like Latino. Was it called Latino Week? Maybe it was. Well, at least now I'm putting out some flowers under the trees. And whoopsie doopsie, now we only, there's only 3,500 civilians left. And now we are looking for the easel and the woodworking table. And those are both base game items. I think that the beehive that we will put down in just a second is from Seasons. Oh, here's the cute barbecue. I would like to have a barbecue like that. They're adorable. I want some more shrubs or plants. Oh, lavender plants. They are so adorable. The purple. Oh, so cute. And now let's go to the beehive. And some planters. I just want to say thank you all for watching, and we will soon be listening to some music while you're watching the screenshots. So I'm just gonna say take care and thank you for watching. I hope you'll be back. Bye.